What could be more important than a little something to eat?
Winnie the Pooh is one of those characters that you're sort of just born knowing about.
Lovely day, isn't it?
Wish I could say yes.
We thought it was a great chance to take these really beloved characters and bring them to the screen again.
Consider yourself pounced.
I think we've all got a weakness for funny animals.
Oh, really? Stick it to me now!
Oh, dear.
It's right back to the original. It's the one everybody fell in love with. And we're back.
It's only me.
Christopher Robin!
Oh, not to worry, Tommy. I always know what to do.
The entire story takes place in the course of a day. Pooh wakes up in the morning, absolutely famished. So that sets him out on his journey to find some honey. And in the process of visiting his friends, he actually discovers that his pal Eeyore has no tail.
That accounts for a good deal.
So they decide to have a contest to find Eeyore's tail. The winner of that contest will ultimately get a pot of honey, which, of course, Winnie the Pooh wants more than anyone.
Just then, Pooh spotted a note.
I did.
Pooh can't make heads or tails of it.
It says, "Gone out, busy Baxon. Owl is a little at sea because Pooh and Piglet and Eeyore have come to them with this monumental task, which basically he doesn't know what to do. Our dear friend Christopher Robin has been captured."
What?
"By a creature called the Baxon."
Much of the story revolves around their attempts to trap this beast that is in the Hundred Acre Wood.
Misspellings and misinterpretations ensues, and you're never going to believe this, but they go off on the wrong tangent. Who'd have thunk it?
Little bit more. Ooh, there you are.
One area that we thought we could, sort of update was the humor. And we started with casting.
I like the sound of that.
The wonderful voice actor Jim Cummings does both those characters. Pooh and Tigger, those are very iconic voices.
Is that you, Tommy?
Beehives are not on my list of facts and friendly items.
In the case of Rabbit, his voice is provided by the wonderful Tom Kenny.
What kind of guy is Rabbit? I would have to say, if you had to pick one word, fuss budget.
That cheeky honey will honey twice before honeying our honey again.
Steve had the great idea of Craig Ferguson as Owl. I mean, he's hilarious. He really has come through for us. He kind of steals the movie.
The directors have a pretty clear idea of what they want, but it's not rigid. Because the directors are happy to let us play, we can do different variations as we've been doing.
Can you tie a knot?
I can knot knot.
Not not?
Who's there?
Pooh.
Pooh who?
No.
What's fun about this movie is the style in which it's made. We went back to make sure it had that sort of watercolor feel of the original.
The look of Disney animation in the 60s and 70s were the animators' drawings. And we needed to embrace that and find a way to maintain that for Winnie the Pooh, because it's such a part of the look of those original shorts.
To that end, we're animating the characters in that style. So it's hand-drawn.
Because that's Winnie the Pooh. And this style of Winnie the Pooh kind of celebrates drawing.
Deep in the Hundred Acre Wood, where Christopher Robin plays.
We definitely wanted to open the movie with the classic Winnie the Pooh song. So Zoe Deschanel felt like, to us, the best idea. She opens the movie with so much freshness.
A donkey named Eeyore is his friend.
We did the first song, which is Winnie the Pooh, written by the Sherman Brothers. And then I did a very important thing to do. And then I was fortunate enough to write a song for the end credits. This has been one of the most fun experiences I've ever had, and I've been just thanking my lucky stars that I have gotten to work on this movie.
First, issue a reward to the...
I beg your pardon?
Why, you sneezed.
I didn't sneeze.
No, you did, Owl.
The word is issue, not at you.
There's a wholesome kind of wonderful sweet aspect to the stories and to the characters.
This isn't an update. We're not trying to give the characters modern contrivances. We wanted to keep it classic, keep it ageless.
In the audience, you can expect everything you loved about the originals, from the music to the look to the characters to the portrayals of them, and all that and more.
Silly old bear.